Stuart Nash has resigned as police minister after admitting he encouraged police commissioner Andrew Costa to appeal a court decision. Opposition parties are now calling for Nash to be stripped of his other portfolios. For more, we're joined by Labour's Arena Williams and National Simeon Brown. Morena, you two, thank you so much. Arena, what was minister thinking?
Oh, look, Stuart Nash made an error of judgment in 2021 when he called the police commissioner when he wasn't the Minister of Police. He's reflected on that and he offered the Prime Minister his resignation, which was swiftly accepted.
Reflected on a call he made in 2021, Arden.
Yeah, exactly. It was a little while ago, and he's thought about how that affects his ability to continue in the police portfolio, and he's made a judgment that it's not tenable for him to continue in that role. I can say that working with my colleague Stuart Nash, I know that he loves that job in the police portfolio. He won't be able to do that anymore, and it would have been a grave decision for him.
Well, the reality is there's no consequences here for Stuart Nash. He wasn't the Minister of Police when he committed the offence. He's now no longer the Minister of Police, but he's still in Cabinet. And so he hasn't actually lost anything. The reality is that it doesn't matter whether he's the Minister of Police. He breached the Cabinet manual. He breached the Policing Act. And the reality is he should go as a Cabinet Minister because there is a clear separation between ministers and Cabinet and what the police do in their job of actually policing. And so he has breached those rules, and the rules should be clear. He should go.
The rules in the Cabinet manual are clear, as well as the Policing Act, which Simeon has mentioned. But we've seen Prime Ministers stand in Parliament over many years and have to make really difficult decisions about whether their ministers will keep their roles. In this instance, it was proportionate to what Stuart Nash had done, that he should lose his police portfolio going forward. That was really quick. You know, we saw yesterday morning the Prime Minister's office finding out about the interview, and then before question time, his portfolio was gone from
him. This government is soft on crime and soft on cabinet ministers who commit offences. The reality is he was a cabinet minister when he committed that offence, and the clear rules are that if cabinet ministers should not be intervening or calling up the police commissioner to intervene in individual cases. He's breached that rule and he should go. And this is not leadership at all. This is soft on crime and soft on cabinet ministers.
And Arena, is it concerning, though, that a senior minister who's been a minister for 6 years now didn't know the rules?
It's vitally important that we maintain that separation between our cabinet and senior public officials, especially the police. Our cabinet ministers do appreciate the rules and do, in general, follow them. I think what we're seeing here is a cabinet minister who has had it brought to his attention that he didn't act in the best way. He made an unwise decision then, and that's why he offered the Prime Minister very quickly his resignation from that portfolio.
But he's still in cabinet, and that's the issue here. Is actually there's been no consequence for Stuart Nash, and the reality is, as a minister, he was a minister then, he's a minister now, and the rules are very clear. This is not leadership, this is just trying to brush it under the carpet for Chris Hipkins, mate.
We have a graphic made up with the rules, just so our viewers can see it, because, of course, for a lot of us, we're not in politics and we're not in Parliament and we don't understand the rules. But even I and even our viewers at home would go, come on, we know what's expected of our ministers and we know what's expected of our politicians in general. Although, in fairness, Simeon, Christopher Luxon had to demote Barbara Kruger from her portfolio about 5 months ago. What is it with all of our politicians not understanding what the rules are?
Well, the reality is Chris Luxon demoted Barbara Kruger from her portfolios. Stuart Nash still has his portfolios, just he doesn't have the police one. He's still in cabinet around the cabinet table. He's breached the cabinet manual, he's breached the Policing Act, but he's still around the big table making decisions around issues such as our police force and funding and how many police officers. The cabinet manual has been breached. He's still around that cabinet table. It's unacceptable.
I think the point that you made, Maddie, about people, you know, broadly appreciating that politicians shouldn't get involved with senior officials is a good one. When public servants do their work, they need to be politically neutral and they need to maintain that separation away from politicians. In this case, there's also the Policing Act, which sets out that the police commissioner has that degree of independence. And in 16.2 of that act, it says that the police commissioner commissioner isn't accountable to ministers or any politicians about decisions that they make about operational issues. So those rules are important to follow, and that's why there's been a consequence in this case.
All right, I want to move on to the polls that were released this week. Both major parties have had a bit of a dip in the polls. The minor parties have had a bit of an increase. But what is interesting to a lot of people, Simeon, is that Christopher Luxon has dropped further in the preferred Prime Minister poll, down 5% to 17%. What conversations are being had in National around that?
Well, the reality is the polls bounce around, and we're right behind Christopher Luxon. He's our leader. He's doing a great job getting around the country and doing the work around policy as well. And we've got a job to do to convince New Zealanders at this year's election that there's a need for change, with the cost of living where it's going, with crime out of control and all these other issues that this government's not addressing. We're right behind Christopher Luxon as we do that job. And he's doing an excellent job at that.
Are you telling me no conversations are being had within the party?
No, we're focused on the issues that matter to New Zealanders, like the cost of living, crime, making sure that we're dealing with the challenges in our education system, all of those other issues, infrastructure, building those roads which need to be rebuilt. That's what we're going to the election to talk about. Those are the issues that matter to New Zealanders at home having breakfast right now. We're not focused on internal talking to ourselves. We want to talk about the issues which matter to New Zealanders.
I don't know, we know what happened in 2017 when Labor dumped their leader this close to the election, and it worked out pretty well for them. Any advice for Simeon and National?
No, that's a matter for National to work through for themselves. But what I can say is that, you know, for us within the Labor government, we're focused on the issues which are mattering for New Zealanders right now. We're not really talking about what their internal issues are. It's the cost of living, and this government is making advances into that to make things better for people.
Well, Kiwis are going backwards under this government. All right. And that's why All we right. need to change a government in All right. October.
All right, we've got to go, you two. Thank you so much for being with us. That's Simeon Brown and Aruna Williams. Really appreciate your time this morning.
Thank you.
Ka kite.